Yeah, it's as true here. Today I'm doing a little bit of electrical work, just a simple receptacle replacement. Now, this is an outdoor receptacle here at the house in Florida. Beautiful trees, palm trees, yay. So, anyway, what's going on here is this is an outside receptacle right near the door here. And it's about 18 years old, give or take. I don't know. We bought the house 10 years ago, so I don't know how much work we've done. Anyway, so this is a GFCI. Ground fault circuit interrupter that's connected to the bathroom on the inside of the house. Well, the GFC, there's actually a button that you push in there on the GFCI that resets it, and it kept popping, and we weren't getting power to that outlet, and there was no power to this outlet. So I'm just showing you guys basically what was going on here is there's a massive amount of corrosion on here. So if your GFCI is popping on a regular basis, or if you have an outlet that doesn't work, you might check and see if it's connected to a GFCI and whether that GFCI has a problem, because it's for safety. If this had continued to corrode and that circuit interrupter hadn't popped, you know, it could cause a fire. So anyway, I just thought I'd show you that that's what's going on here. That's why this outlet wasn't working and why the other bathrooms were not working as well, because they're all in the same circuit on the circuit breaker there. If you're doing any, I wouldn't recommend doing electrical work yourself unless you have experience. You know, just know how not to be ripped off by an electrician. Don't make an electrician tell you, oh, you need to get your whole house rewired, blah, 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 when it could just be a ground fault circuit interrupter. So I'm going to just put on a new receptacle here. And, you know, if you're safe about wiring, you know, always have a tester. And turn off the breaker. Don't turn off switches. Well, obviously, with receptacles, you got to turn off the breaker because there's no switch for this. You know, most simple receptacles, you just look where the wire, where the neutral wire was, and then on the other one where the hot wire is, the black wire, and then you just replace it in those exact same places. So when I take the white wire off here, and put it on there. But, you know, if you're a do-it-yourselfer, watch a couple more videos on YouTube on how to do this and how to be safe, and it is something you can fix yourself. You don't want to get zapped, though. That's what I'm just saying, is electricity can stop your heart. It may not kill you, but if nobody's around to help you and resuscitate you, when you get zapped by household electricity, that can be a problem. Also, if you're on a ladder, it can definitely throw you backwards, and you can land on a sharp object or hit your head, and that can also kill you. So, safety around electricity is really important. I took a class to get certified to be an electrician, but I did not take the state test. So I learned pretty much all the safety rules and all the codes and everything you're supposed to do, but I'm not certified to work on a commercial house or other people's houses. I just do it on my own. So guys, here you go again. Like I said, the reason that GFCI in the bathroom was malfunctioning was because of this rust and corrosion here, and so it shut off the circuit breaker in the bathroom. And that's it, like I said, that's a little switch that pops and clicks where it says test. They're usually red and black, but they can also just be little ones with a little light on them in the bathroom. So guys, this is Drew, and sorry I haven't posted in a while. We've been here at the house in Florida, and we have been setting things up to sell the house, and it actually did sell recently. It's under contract. The contract hasn't gone through, but I'll be posting a video showing you guys how we sold the house in about 30 days and how much money we saved, some techniques we used by selling the house ourselves. Okay guys, well, for you guys, the subscribers, thanks for watching, and I know you guys are the first ones getting this video, so this is a shout out to you guys. My subscribers are the ones that you guys always watch. And then eventually these videos end up in the search on YouTube and other people see them. So if you're one of those folks, welcome to my channel. Thanks again for watching, and I hope you can fix your electrical problems, and I hope you can be safe about it. Okay, well, have a good one, guys. This is Drew with Drew's Quick Fixes and Hacks. Make sure you hit that subscribe button if you're not a subscriber, and get those notifications.